Mr. Hartright. What are you doing in my private quarters? I often take walks by the lake, Mr. Hartright. Don't see any crime in it, do you? Never seen any such thing as a woman dressed in white round these premises. However, I can tell you I just laid eyes on a young lady who appeared desperate to see you, Mr. Hartright. Miss Laura Fairley is waiting for you in the parlour. I don't know how to say this. On my father's deathbed, I promised that I'd marry Sir Percival Glyde. I made a solemn oath that I'd become his wife. I was very young, and now I'm not so sure. But Sir Percival is arriving tomorrow. Yes, I must. But Walter, I saw the woman in white outside, near the churchyard. I don't know how to describe it, Walter, but I feel that she knows something. Something that is very important to my future. You must find her. I saw the woman in white near my mother's grave. Through those doors. Yes, Walter. Call it women's intuition. Laura and I both feel this poor creature from our past is somehow linked to our future. Her mother adored her as a girl, so there must be some good in her. Please find out what she is trying to tell us. Thank you.
arrival of Sir Percival Glyde, the man Laura agreed to marry at the dying request of her late father. From all appearances, Sir Percival was a far more worthy mate than I. A baronet. Surely, Laura would live a happy, full life with him. Yet the note left by Anne, the woman in white, she warned Laura not to marry Percival because of some deep, dark secret. What is his secret? Is Laura in danger? Broken-hearted, I left England for several months. During my absence, Laura married Percival, but things soon turned for the worse. While abroad, I received a letter from Marion, who said that Percival Glyde was not what he appeared. He was a desperate man, and Marion feared that Laura was in danger. So I dropped everything and made my way to Glyde's estate, the Blackwater Park. Marion said I would not be welcome there, so I entered secretly through the cellar doors.